Four-day U.S. embassy takeover and is now a reformist member of the Tehran City Council. She says the film doesn't tell the story of the takeover as it actually happened.
There's no commotion, violence. The scenes that you see in the in Argo are totally incorrect. And it's quite surprising because that footage exists. If Ben Affleck wanted to make a movie out of the reality, depicting the reality of what happened, he should have at least used some parts of the actual historical event, the footage which...
Embassy, that you would destroy the hostages. Could you really do that?
Yes, we mean it.
Could you personally lift up a gun? Yes. Put it to the head of one of these people and kill him?
Yes, when I have seen a gun being lifted up, an American machine gun being lifted up, and killing my sisters and brothers in the streets. Of course, oppression and tyranny must be destroyed.
What about the question of what is going to happen to the hostages now? I mean, it's been said that there's going to be a trial. Do you want these people to go on trial?
Yes, these people, if the Shah is not returned.
And but he's not going to be returned, is he? Do you really believe that he'll be returned?
Yeah, we believe they should return him.
But that's another question. Do you believe he will be returned?
And they have to. If they don't return him, the trials will start, and the hostages will be tried, and they'll be tried in a Islamic court, and the sentences will be carried out on them, based on Islamic principles.
Are you at all worried that there could be some kind of psychological damage?
During the holy festival of Ashura, columns of flagellants whip themselves with an enthusiasm that hasn't been seen for years. Perhaps this is what Khomeini and his clergy wanted, for their popularity was just beginning to sag in the face of the mounting economic problems that their revolution has brought about. If this was their aim, some amongst them must now be feeling just a little worried, for they're still on collision course with the world's most powerful nation, and neither Khomeini nor the students show any sign of backing down.
But how much longer can you go on doing this?
We are ready to go on until martyrdom, and we will struggle and fight.
What does it mean, martyrdom? What does it mean?
Martyrdom is a unique philosophy only for Islam, and it means that when man struggles in the way of his goals until the height of being killed in the way of his goals, in the way of God, that's martyrdom. And martyrs are alive in Islam. Martyrs do not die. Martyrs are not destroyed. They always exist.
So the bullets do not really kill?
The bullets do not kill. And that is the message that the people of Iran gave to all oppressed peoples of the world. That bullets do not kill faith. Bullets do not kill humanity. Bullets do not kill the rights of the